Hello, I am Dr. Barbara Jobst, and I am the Louis and Ruth Frank Professor of Neurosciences, and I am also the director of the Dartmouth-Hitchcock Epilepsy Center. I would like to tell you today about our exciting research that concerns epilepsy, brain stimulation, and memory. I started my career as a clinical neurologist, seeing patients who have terrible seizures, patients like Leanne. And let me tell you about Leanne. Leanne had seizures that did not respond to medications or even surgical therapy. She was a candidate for a research study I was involved in very early in my career. She came in with her elderly parents, and as part of the informed consent, I had to tell her that she's a candidate for the study. However, we are not quite sure how the device would work and whether it would work at all. There are risks involved, like having an infection or having bleeding into her brain. Her parents were steadfast against doing this. They called it an experiment, and which was true. I had to agree with that. And they didn't want her to have anything done that concerns no benefit for her. Leanne was sitting there for a few moments and then thought, okay, this may not help me, but it may help somebody in the future. Therefore, I would like to enroll into the study. For that reason, we made it our mission that all research we do needs to really concern and change patients' lives. Luckily, Leanne did quite well in terms of her seizures and had reduced seizures. She had a master's degree but could still not work for the reason that not only the seizures, but she also had associated memory problems and could not remember what she was told when she was on the job. So with the years then, we expanded our research while listening to patients like Leanne and other patients that not only the seizures are a problem, but there are also problems with their memory. So we have worked on identifying brain waves that indicate that you have a good memory state or that you have a poor memory state. We were able in the hospital to improve memory in a wordless task. However, our life does not quite consist out of word lists all the time. So we would like to expand this research really to a more naturalistic environment. So we would like to study events like, why does somebody walk into the kitchen and forget what they wanted to get in the kitchen? Or like, why do patients forget the content of movies they saw the night before? And our ultimate goal is to really to invent a brain stimulator like this one for seizures that would treat seizures as well as the memory problems. While we were doing this work, we also thought about another way how we possibly could improve seizures. And that brings me to this program here called Hopscotch, which is based on an age-old principle of cognitive behavioral therapy. What this is, the patient gets assigned a memory coach and is on the phone with the coach every 2 weeks. So it's part of telehealth. The patient identifies a memory problem, like for example, every time I go into the laundry room, I forget the socks, and then learns from the memory coach strategies how to overcome this problem, and identifies one solution, such as I put a sign on the door to the staircase to the laundry room, or I remind my husband to tell me every time I go down the stairs to take the socks. Or another way is to really visualize socks really big in front of the staircase, and miraculously the next time you will remember not to forget the socks. And we have proven that this program really improves memory and also quality of life. However, the next challenge is really in our research to identify ways to distribute programs like this and other programs to a larger population, how this can work in regular medical care, and how this can be implemented in health systems. To continue our work, we don't only want to study this in epilepsy, we also want to study these things which concern brain stimulation as well as programs like Hopscotch in other disease states such as Alzheimer's disease, traumatic brain injury, or stroke. For that, we would ask you for your support to support our exciting research in the future. Our dream is to do this in a brain institute where neuroscientists, physicians, engineers, and psychologists could work together to really improve the lives of patients like Leanne, because they more than deserve it. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Barbara. That was a really interesting presentation. And one of the questions I had that you did talk about was the application of your research beyond seizures to diseases like Alzheimer's, maybe Parkinson's, and others. Could you go into a little bit more detail? Because that's really fascinating work, and what you see the applications beyond just seizures actually being.
With patients with epilepsy, we have a unique opportunity to study brainwaves inside their brain. So we would like what we learn from patients in epilepsy with brain stimulation. After we learn that, we can easily take this to patients with Alzheimer's disease, for example, and do the same stimulation paradigms in other diseases. But we need to find out whether basically Alzheimer's brains and epilepsy brains are somewhat similar. Another possibility would be to just implement Hopscotch or some similar program in patients with Alzheimer's disease or Parkinson's disease. And that's definitely where we want to take our research as a next step.
Thank you very much. Fascinating.
That's great. Well, this was a terrific presentation. Thank you so much. And as our population continues to age, this problem is going to just continue, and it touches so many people's lives. My father actually was just diagnosed with Alzheimer's, so I'm sort of thinking, like, how would this have helped him in a future state? So my question for you is, if you get funding to really increase the possibilities for your research, what do you see as a future state, you know, maybe 5, 10, 15 years from now? What would you like to see if you get this type of funding?
So I would like to see, first of all, I would like to see that easy programs like the Hopscotch can be easily implemented, that they are supported by insurances and health payers, that patients have access to them, that patients, like in Alzheimer's disease, can come to it early before the Alzheimer's disease gets really very severe. And also, in addition to those programs like Hopscotch, maybe then implant a brain stimulator that really improves memory. So the future I would see, first of all, in epilepsy, that the memory problem is not so much an issue, and that Leanne could go back to her job and work. In Alzheimer's disease, that we can delay until the severe memory loss kicks in with either stimulation or what's called self-management programs like Hopscotch. Or in Parkinson's, the same thing, that the memory problem is not so much of a problem in addition to all the motor problems they have. If somebody has problems after a stroke, we can also implement this, and maybe with learning strategies and doing some brain stimulation, the memory, if there is impairment, is not a problem.
Well, that's terrific. We wish you all the best, because this is such important work that really will have a huge impact. So thank you very much for being with us today.
Thank you very much.